issued the first Surgeon General's advisory in over 10 years earlier this year, helping folks understand that over half of our opioid overdoses are occurring in a home setting. We all know that a noxic brain injury occurs in 4 to 5 minutes. We also all know that most ambulances and first responders aren't going to show up in 4 to 5 minutes. Therefore, if we want to make a dent in this overdose epidemic, we need everyone to consider themselves as a first responder. We need to look at it the same as we look at CPR. We're talking about tourniquets. We need to arm everyone in our society to carry naloxone. How can healthcare providers help? They can co-prescribe naloxone to folks on high morphine milligram equivalents who are at risk. It's not the best way of doing things, but sometimes if grandma has naloxone at home and grandson overdoses in the garage, then at least naloxone is in the house. Communities that have saturated
to carry the medication naloxone. It's also called Narcan, and it's the drug first responders use to reverse an opioid overdose. I spoke to the U.S. Surgeon General, Vice Admiral Jerome Adams, about why ordinary Americans should be prepared to prevent someone from dying from opioids.
Over half of the overdoses that are occurring in homes, and so we want everyone to be armed to respond. We should think of it like an EpiPen or like doing CPR on someone.
Is there any kind of risk in having everyday Americans armed with naloxone? I mean, is it difficult to administer? Are there any risks if administering it incorrectly? Do people need training?
One of the things that we're doing is working with pharmacies, working with providers, working with the American Medical Association and the nursing associations to increase training on how to administer naloxone in homes. But overall, and I'm an anesthesiologist who's administered naloxone many times myself, it is easy to use, and 49 out of 50 states have standing orders for people to be able to access and use naloxone in the home setting because it is a safe drug where the benefits definitely outweigh the risk, particularly in the midst of an epidemic.
What about paying for it? I mean, this is...
He goes on later to say, if you've got diabetic coma or hypertension, that's two more breathing emergencies right in this interview. The man's a mass murderer. He's an anesthesiologist. The only thing keeping you alive during surgery is ventilations. They never give you CPR. You tell the general public CPR, they immediately think chest compressions. They're killing non-drug overdoses and drug overdoses because the signs of drug overdose mimic any of the hundreds of causes of breathing emergency.